Introduction. The mission: to undertake each engineering venture with the aim of providing the highest standard in quality, efficiency, cost effectiveness, safety and environmental preservation. Next, the vision: to develop Jurutera Perundi Zabah Sdn Bhd as a premier international engineering company with advanced technologies and all-around capabilities. And lastly, the objective: we provide services that not only help clients meet their target, but in a way that helps sustain our delicate ecosystem.
Next, this is the organization chart for Jurutera Perundi Zabah Sdn Bhd Company. Next, for personal point, basically in Jurutera Perundi Zabah Sdn Bhd, there are 80 staff including the managing director. In the past, actually they have around 200 staff working in their company. However, after the COVID-19 pandemic, they have to reduce the number of staff available to 100 people only. In addition, there are three main parties in the company, which are the architect, engineer, and contractor. Besides that, for the daily attendance management process, they have three main persons that will be responsible and in charge in the process, which are the human resource clerk, human resource executive, and human resource manager. Next, for the equipment, Jurutera Perundi Zabah Sdn Bhd use a few equipment in the daily attendance management process. The first one is punch card and punch card machine, which are used for the staff to check in and check out from the office. The second one is the daily attendance management system, which refer to the software that are used by the human resource to identify and calculate the total number of the staff present or absent per day. Next, the computer, which are used to key in the data or information about the staff, especially about their leave report. And the last one is the printer that are used to print all the data and information of the daily attendant.
Next, the call process. The daily attendance management process flowchart was created in the company of Jurutera Perundi Zabah Sdn Bhd to create an accurate graphical depiction of everything related to hours work and time off. The human resource clerk in this organization is in charge of keeping track of which employees are working, when they are working, and when they have scheduled time off. Attendance management is critical for any company with employee, since the data gathered through this reporting may help establish whether the organization is on the right track and pace for future success. In addition, companies can also detect which employee arrive early, on time, or consistently late by monitoring the attendance. Following, the internal and external customer. The staff and human resource clerk are the internal customer in this daily attendance management process system of Jurutera Perundi Zabah Sdn Bhd. The daily attendance management process system is used by both the staff and the human resource clerk to keep track of the employee's attendance and the total number of hours worked. Employee clock-in and clock-out hours, as well as how often they are present at their workplace, will be tracked by this system. It is also enable the system to determine the number of hours that employee work. While the external customer in the daily attendance management process system are the Ministry of Human Resource. As we are in the midst of COVID-19 outbreak, the Ministry of Human Resource is implementing flexible employee scheduling.
This is the flowchart of this process. The explanation of each process will be explained by the next presenter, which is Nur Natasha.
The description of SE's process. The name of SE's is Daily Attendance Management Process by Jurutera Perundi Zabah Sdn Bhd. This system is used by the company to keep track of employee daily attendance from Monday to Friday. It can be operated by tracking how much time employees spend at work and how much time they spend off. To use this system, the human resource clerk needs to access Excel, where it collects all the data regarding the daily attendance management process system. This system is also made by the human resource clerk since 2010. Now, I will explain the step of the process. Step 1. Identify absent staff. The first step in conducting the manual daily attendance process is Mrs. Melina Muhammad Amin as human resource clerk. We identify those absent staff from punch card in and out. All staff are required to clock in into their manual attendance process before 9 a.m. that has been set out by the company, or else attendance will be counted late. Step 2. Identify person absent. Next, after After the manual attendance process ends at 9 a.m., Mrs. Melina Muhammad Amin will check absent list name one by one through the punch card. If the staff does not punch his or her card in the office, this will indicate they are not present in the office. This step will take about 30 minutes to clarify by Mrs. Melina Muhammad Amin every day. Step 3. Leave approved online. In this stage, Human Resource Clerk Mrs. Melina Muhammad Amin need to identify either the absent staff got an approved leave or not. If the staff leave are approved, it will be appear in the manual leave record. However, if the leave are not recorded in the manual, that indicate the staff is not apply any leave before the day arrive. Step 4. Call each department clerk. Next, if the staff are absent with unrecorded leave, Mrs. Melina is the responsible person to call the department to get the confirmation of the absent staff. This process usually took about 25 minutes to be confirmed by the department. The department is responsible to check and find why the person is not present in the office. Step 5. Check leave record. Furthermore, there are two conditions in this process where the staff are absent with approved leave or not. If the staff is absent with approved leave, Mrs. Melina can check through employee leave record book. However, if the person is absent without approved leave, Mrs. Melina need to check with the department involved to reconfirm the reason behind it. Step 6. Record manually absent staff. After that, Mrs. Melina Muhammad Amin as Human Resource Clerk is responsible to record manually in the daily attendance report of absent staff. She need to update the employee leave record book with the current update from those absent staff. This process will be updated every day before 10 a.m. before proceeding to the next step. Step 7. Submit to Human Resource Executive. When the Human Resource Clerk, Ms. Melina, has recorded the absent staff manually, then Ms. Melina need to submit the daily attendance report to the Human Resource Executive for review. As Nur Shahnaz Binti Muhammad Qasim is the Human Resource Executive, she is responsible to review the daily attendance report of absent staff. The purpose of reviewing the report is to make sure there is no error when submitting the report to the Human Resource Manager. Step 8. Data correct or not. The Human Resource Executive, Nur Shahnaz, will be reviewing and double-checking the report to find any incorrect data that occurs before submitting it to the Human Resource Manager. Step 9. Make correction of the data. If there is an error on the report submitted, the Human Resource Executive will instruct the Human Resource Clerk to make correction. And lastly, step 10. Submit report to Human Resource Manager. However, if there is no incorrect data and everything is complete with the correct information and details, the Human Resource Executive, Ms. Nur Shahnaz, will submit the report to the Human Resource Manager named Encik Ahmad Nazri bin Ibrahim for approval. Then, the daily attendance report need to be kept in the file for reference in the future.
Next, there are three current situation analysis for Jurutera Perunding Sabah Sdn. Bhd in daily attendance management process. The first one is the staff. The process of applying leave is very slow. It is because the staff need to fill in the application form manually. After that, they need to wait for the approval that will take 3 to 5 days depending on the manager's time. Other than that is the human resource clerk. The process of getting the data and information of the staff present or absent is slow and time-consuming. It is because the human resource clerk need to call the human resource of each department one by one to get the confirmation of their staff either they present or absent. Meanwhile, the human resource clerk need to be wait around 30 minutes to get the data and information from the human resource of each department. After getting the data and information from the staff, the human resource of each department need to inform the human resource clerk to make sure the data and information is correct and parallel with the daily attendance management system. The last one is there are too many persons are involved in the daily attendance management process, such as the human resource of each department. In this company, they have 6 departments and each of the departments have their own human resource clerk. However, even though each of the departments have their own human resource clerk, but the company still hire another human resource clerk that will be specific in charge and responsible in the daily attendance management system instead of using the 6 human resource clerk that already have in their company. If there are too many persons involved in the process, it will be caused inaccurate data. This is because the data and information are come from various sources which can lead to many errors and data duplication. Next, this is the fishbone diagram. This fishbone diagram is based on the current situation analysis that I already explained on the previous slide. There are three causes of daily attendance management process is slow. The first one is because of the process of the staff applying the leave application is slow. The staff need to fill in the form manually and wait for the approval about 3 to 5 days of working hours. The second cause is because the process to get data and information of the staff present or absent is slow and time consuming. Human resource clerk need to call human resource of each department one by one and wait around 30 minutes to get the response. The last cause is because of too many person involved in the process. In this company, they have 6 human resource clerk from each department and plus one another human resource clerk that in charge and responsible in the daily attendance management system.
Next, I will be presenting about names and responsibility of each person in charge. Firstly, Ms. Helena Muhammad Amin as human resource clerk will conduct and supervise the daily attendance process system every day to track and trace employees' presence in the office. Secondly, Ms. Nur Shahnaz Muhammad Kasim will review the daily attendance report every day to make sure if in case any correction of data need to be made. And lastly, all the decisions and approval will be approved by Mr. Nazri Ahmad Ibrahim as human resource manager. Next, name of the to-be process. This process called daily e-attendance management system. This system will help human resource department to keep track with all the employees' presence in the office, and at the same time, it will help human resource department to reduce time consuming of overall process into 15 minutes and below. I will be discussing about cross-functional of 2B process. Step 1, clock in into e-attendance system. All employees are required to clock in into their e-attendance system before entering their workspace. This company has limited their clock-in attendance before 9 a.m. or otherwise, their status will be turned into late. Step 2, system will generate the attendance. System will automatically generate the list of name of present staff followed by the absent staff. Furthermore, Ms. Melina Muhammad Amin will review the list of name and it require only less than 7 minutes. Step 3 is staff on approved leave. Those absent staff with approved leave will appear their names in the system automatically, but for those who are absent with unapproved leave, system will develop 3 possibilities which are could be he or she on emergency leave, outstation, or forget to clock in into their e-attendance. Step 4, identify absent reason. Ms. Melina Muhammad Amin as human resource clerk will identify those who did not clock in into their e-attendance by calling their department. Usually, this will take approximately 10 to 15 minutes for Ms. Melina to figure out what is the reason and why they are not present in the office. Step 5, manually key in into the system. In this step, Ms. Melina Muhammad Amin at Human Resource Clerk also responsible to key in those absence names that did not appear in the e-attendance system for a reference. She will update from time to time before 9 a.m. and submission towards the next person. Step 6, submit names to Human Resource Executive. After all the list name are being identified and key it in the system, all those names will be sent and verified by Ms. Nur Shahnaz Muhammad Kasim as Human Resource Executive. She will identify and check whether the list of name have any incorrect data. If she identify any incorrect data, she will return the list of name towards Ms. Melina Muhammad Amin for any amendments. Step 7, submit the report to HR manager for approval. In this step, after all the corrections have been made, Ms. Nur Shahnaz Muhammad Kasim will send the report towards Mr. Nazri Ibrahim for approval. He will keep the report for future reference. Next, I will be discuss about the benefits of 2P process. Firstly, reduce time consuming. Previously, this company using manually punch card in and out and they need to punch card before 9 a.m. once they arrive in the office. Then, Ms. Melina Muhammad Amin need to review and check the absent names one by one through the punch card. But then, with the presence of the new system, which is the new e-attendance system, it will speed up the process of attendance every day. Secondly, fair for other employees. With the presence of this new e-attendance system, it can recognize each of the employee because they are using a signed email by the company, and then there will be no issue of unfair or fraud. And at the same time, this system will be updated from time to time. At the same time, Human Resource Department also can review those employees who have poor attendance record. Last benefit, which is easy to use and control. Miss Melina Muhammad Amin do not have to bother around because this system is very effective and convenient. And at the same time, this system is quicker to set up and need less time to deploy. And also, this system can be accessed in just a few minutes, anytime and anywhere.
So next, I will be proceeding with the conclusion of business process improvement of company Jurutera Perunding Zabah Sdn Bhd. So based on the table, there are two types of measurement which can help to measure how well the system works with the employees, which are qualitative measurement and quantitative measurement. This measurement can help the employee to keep on improving their daily attendance system, which can call it as e-attendance. So the first point for qualitative measurement found that 90% staff work performance can be enhanced. The e-attendance system helps to track the staff performance based on their attendance. So for example, Human Resource Department might see in the most recent attendance which staff is consistently late. So they can ask the staff why they always been late in the recent week or missing in action without any notice to the company. Other than that, Human Resource Department may discover about the staff tardiness is due to personal or domestic concern. Next, the second qualitative measurement found that 90% staff rating e-attendance system as excellent. So this measure help whether the employees is comfortable in using the new system or not. The e-attendance system show a good result as the system is portable and can be keyed in through mobile devices and in need of internet data to access the system. Additionally, it does not require the staff to punch in and punch out from work using the punch card manually. The employees rate the e-attendance system as excellent and convenient to use, and they also satisfied with the process in the system. We move on to quantitative measurement. It found that 90% number of staff is using e-attendance system. Due to technology advancement, it can fulfill their satisfaction as it is easy and convenient to use, which can save a lot of their times rather than to punch card manually in the office. Another 10% disagree because they found out that e-attendance system is difficult to use because they are not used to technology, especially among the baby boomers. Next, 90% of time consuming can be decreased by using e-attendance system. Before this, Human Resource Department took about 30 minutes only to retrieve the leave records manually to confirm the absent staff is on their leave or missing in action. This method does take a lot of time just to know whereabouts of the missing in action person because the process will need to be done in manually method. After e-attendance have been generated, Human Resource Department only took 10 minutes to figure out the reason of those absent staff. The new system will automatically identify which staff does not clock in without any reason. As a result, a business project re-engineering can be the most difficult task once performed. It takes a strategy to a business that includes this critical success factor in order to be successful. Firstly, a methodology and project approach. Discipline and structure are required for every re-engineering process along with the methodology that must be systematic and fact-focused. Previously, Jurutera Perunding Zabah Sdn Bhd only used manually recorded punch card for their daily attendance management. It is a hassle for Human Resource Department as they have to check one by one staff record if their total number are not meet than it should be, and usually it took about 30 minutes just to retrieve back the staff record to find the reason why the staff are missing in action or either they are on leave. To enhance their daily attendance system, they have come up with a new system named e-attendance. As the result, Human Resource Department only took 10 minutes to get the reason from the system on why the staff absent during the day. Next, visible and active relationship. This one is the most crucial for critical success factor. Business re-engineering requires CEOs and managers to show a long-term commitment in terms of dollar, people and executive visibility. So as we can see in Jurutera Perunding Zabah, they have strong bonding throughout the staff and the management. If the staff are found absent, Human Resource Department will reach their department to know where is the staff whereabouts in order to make sure they are in the good condition or not because of the absence. Next, the problem that the team might face in implementing the improved process is the problem that came from the staff itself. So if the staff forgot to key in their attendance, the human resource department still had to call their departments for confirmation. Mrs. Melina Muhammad Amin, as human resource clerk, would call their departments for double confirmation of those employees who did not clock in for their attendance. Therefore, it found out that the system still need human workforce to work on its system. It is a way long process just to know the absent staff's whereabouts. Other than that, slow internet connection to assess the e-attendance also contribute to the problems. So, due to the slow internet connection, the staff could not access the system during the time they should punch in to work. This could contribute to a bad reputation for the staff as their attendance will state that they are late to work. In addition, human resource department might be receiving a lot of complaints from the staff as they have come to work but could not access the system because due to slow internet connection, and they might have to correct many corrections on the attendance record from the staff complaint. This only be giving the team more additional work to do instead of helping them in reducing their workloads.